We need our laws and our policies to mirror the way that we live and the way that our families are structured, right? We need to remove the barriers that keep a family member from bringing a loved one back into their homes, just straight up, right? Like, we need to let people reunite with their families and move on with their lives. Number two, so a couple years ago, I came across a study that I could not find to cite in time for tonight, but I know it exists, that looks at, right? It says the number one thing that keeps people from re-entering prison, right? It's not determined by like a program or participation in some sort of thing. It's a job that pays a living wage, right? It's a job where you have responsibility, a social network, and enough to take care of yourself and your family. So we need to fight for this at every level, right? Back, I think now 12 years ago, probably a little bit longer, I led a coalition that found the First Source Ordinance that folks were talking about before, found it on the books that wasn't being enforced. And you know, together with DARE, with city councilors, we pushed and pushed and pushed and said, hey, this is a really good opportunity to put people to work, to make sure that people have the wages they need to get by. And when that didn't work, we took the city and the mayor at the time to Superior Court and won. So now there's opportunities, right, for people to be employed in apprenticeship programs in the city, but we need to do more. We need to move that ordinance across the board. We need to fight for it.